city. So when I'm dead and gone, I got one last wish. Put my Yankee hat on.
I put on for my city. On for my city. I put on for my city. On for my city. Put on Eastside. Put on Southside. Put on Westside. Put on.
Hello, Jam Beauties. Welcome back to my channel. And today's review or slash product review is going to be on some products that were sent to me by blackhairspray.com. If you don't already know, they have everything you need. It's like a one-stop shop. Hence the reason why I'm here today, to show you some things that they have. Wigs, edge control, hair products, grease, shampoo, conditioner, etc. You have everything for tools you need for edge brushes, brushes, combs, hair color, eyelashes, which I'm going to show to you today, as well as, you know, array of maintenance for your, you know, skincare, your face, like eyebrow raises, everything. So if you want to see more on the product that I received, please continue to watch. We're going to get into this review, but before I get into this review, if you haven't already and you are enjoying my videos this far, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button and that alert notification bell right next to the subscribe button, so you won't miss another upload and you can, you know, always come back and chill with your girl. So let's get into these products. I did go ahead and do like a mini tutorial just to show you how some of these products work and how I use the product, incorporated it in my look today. So go ahead and check out this clip. So I am back. I hope you enjoyed that mini tutorial or slash review on how I use the products and incorporate it into this look I am currently rocking. I didn't get a chance to use the razor, but obviously these come in major handy, especially when I'm in the salon. I absolutely love to use these. I haven't used this one with this particular handle yet, so I think this is gonna be so much fun. And as far as the nails, I'm actually saving the nails for another review I have coming up with a black hairspray as well. So don't forget to check that out if you wanna see these gorgeous coffin shaped slays. Come back. I did incorporate majority of the rest of the things into this look. My pros and cons. I actually liked everything. The brushes work really well, especially for somebody who's just beginning to get into makeup and, you know, you need something that is affordable. These brushes were super affordable. I'll leave all the prices and the links to everything in the description box below, so don't forget to check that out so you know how much everything costs. The eyeliner was perfect. I really like the matte eyeliner. The Kiss New York Pro Touch Mattifying Primer was really good. That's what I use as the base. As far as the concealers, my favorite concealer, I feel like this reminds me of the LA Girl Pro Concealer, and maybe even a little thicker than that one. So I mean, it was okay. The color was a little off. I feel like these two have a little more of a pinker undertone in them instead of a yellow, which I'm a yellow undertone. And this gave me a little bit of a yellow undertone, and I got this in Rich Caramel. This was the lightest concealer out of all three, which I really like and which I use the most. The biggest shocker for me was this wing liner stencil. This thing works amazingly good. Like, it works amazingly good. Now, when you're going from eye to eye, you do want to wipe it off between each eye so you don't, you know, mess up your makeup and you be pissed off. But this is great for beginners. It worked amazingly well. It's flexible and you just mold it right onto your face and boom, instant wing. So that was a huge shocker for me, which was a huge plus. I love the way it feels. It's soft, it's not hard or rough on the skin. As far as this Letter Series Midnight Adventures Sealed with a Kiss by Ruby Kiss eyeshadow palette, it was decent. I feel like the lighter colors are a little bit chalky. Mainly this white one here was pretty chalky, and this one here wasn't much of a color payoff. But the rest of them swatched decent, which I like, and I use obviously in this look. But it's just great for a beginner. It's very cute, you know, compact, and you throw in your purse. And they come in, I think, another color, a different color than this one. More colors to choose from other than this one. So check that out. Now, let's get into the brush. So this brush reminds me of a boar bristle brush. It's not too hard, but it's not that soft either, so it's perfect for molding. And as I use the bottom of this to pick up the gel, in case you have nails, spread it on and then, you know, mold it. As far as this, I've been wearing this for about a week and a half now, and the hold is nice, but the hold for me in the past week, since it's been really, really hot here in New York, it's only held up for maybe, I wanna say about 5 hours before it starts to melt down, which is, you know, a bummer, but I will say that it doesn't leave any kind of residue. It's not sticky, it's not greasy, so it leaves my hair feeling soft afterwards, which I do like. This was a little expensive. This was about $10 for 4 ounces or 113 grams for this, but it did leave my hair really, really soft. And as you can see, you know, I really do like it. It has a nice scent to it. It has like a nice tropical scent to it, which I do like. I did go ahead and use this to shape my eyebrows off camera. These are easy for people, you know, who don't want to use a blade or waxing or just for a touch up. This is perfect. It comes in 2 different sizes, but you get 4, which is perfect. And they're also inexpensive. Everything here was inexpensive. I do love these lashes. It were a little difficult to stay on. I don't know if it was the band or what, but it's a little difficult to stay on, but you know, I worked it out. Yeah, so that's pretty much it for the products. I do like this. I have been using this as well, and for the most part, it has been keeping my makeup on. I don't know about 24 hours. I would say a good 12 hours. I don't know about 24 hours yet. So this does hold pretty well on my with my makeup and holds up pretty well. I do like it. I've been reaching for this a lot lately, and it does come in, you know, a matte and I think another version of it. You can go ahead and check all of that out at Black Hairspray. Like I said, this whole look was put together by Black Hairspray. I hope you guys like this look, because I really did enjoy reviewing these products. I want to say thank you to Black Hairspray for sending me out this product to review. So until my next video, don't forget to follow me on Instagram. Please like, subscribe, comment, and share. And as always, stay fabulous and be your own vision of beauty. Till next time, bye.